Hi, it's Erin from Silver River Museum. How did you pick out what clothes you have on today? Did either you or someone you live with check the weather? Weather is important to our daily lives. Not only does it tell us what we should wear to school, but it tells us what we can expect for our day and what kind of activities we can plan. Weather is more than just the temperature and whether or not it's going to rain. There are several measurements that scientists will make when they're describing the weather in a particular place and in a particular time. So, of course, we're going to measure the temperature. Now, on the news, we'll hear it measured in degrees Fahrenheit. Scientists will use degrees Celsius. Precipitation includes rain, snow, sleet, and hail. Rain is the most common in Florida, but we can experience other forms of precipitation. Humidity is a measure that tells us how much water vapor is in the air. That's water in its gaseous state. We have tools to measure humidity, but if you've lived through a Florida summer, you also know that your hair can be a measure of humidity. Hair will change in length depending on how humid it is, and that gives us those frizzy hair days when there's lots of water vapor in the air. Air pressure is another very important measurement. Imagine blowing up a balloon. The air that you're putting into that balloon is putting pressure on the sides of the balloon. And you know what happens if you put too much air in a balloon. Well, the air in our atmosphere pushes on us a lot like the air in the balloon pushes on the balloon. And finally, we're going to measure wind. Wind speed and wind direction help us determine the weather as well. Have you heard that different environments can have different weather? Do you want to investigate? I'm at the Swamp Boardwalk in Silver Springs State Park. Take a minute to look around the swamp. What do you notice? How would you describe this environment? Explore the swamp and one additional environment, and let's see how their weather is similar and how it's different. I'm out here in the sandhill, which is only a little bit away from the swamp. I'm still in Silver Springs State Park, but you can see the environment looks very different. Measure the weather for 5 days at the same time of day in both locations. And to measure the weather, I have a special tool. This is a wireless weather probe, and it connects with my cell phone. It will actually record lots of different data. It'll record the temperature, humidity, wind speed, air pressure, among others. How do you think the weather will compare and contrast between the swamp and the sandhill? What evidence or clues do you have to support your prediction? All right, I'm ready to take my measurements. I've got my cell phone ready. I've got my weather sensor ready. I've got to hold my weather sensor high above my head to get the best measurements, and I'm gonna hit start, and I'm gonna let my weather sensor run for 2 whole minutes. All right, I've recorded my weather data. I'm gonna do the same thing for 4 more days, and then we're gonna compare our weather in the sandhill to the swamp and see if the environment makes a difference. Now that we've measured the weather in the swamp and the sandhill, let's take a look at our data and determine how the weather compares and contrasts in these two environments. First, take a look at day one in the swamp, and let's look at temperature. It was 71 degrees in the swamp. Now let's compare that to the sandhill on day one, where the temperature was 73 degrees. So on the same day, it was warmer in the sandhill than in the swamp. Let's continue to look at the other days. What do you notice about the temperature in the swamp versus the sandhill on all of the days? Do you see that on all 5 days, it was warmer in the sandhill than in the swamp? Why do you think that was? Take a look around at the two environments. Did you notice that it's much sunnier in the sandhill and much shadier in the swamp? Do you think that had an effect on temperature? How about humidity? On day one in the swamp, the humidity was 48%. In the sandhill, it was 43%, so it was lower. Let's look at the other days. Do you notice that the humidity was always lower in the sandhill than in the swamp? Remember, humidity is water vapor in the air, which means having a source of water nearby can affect your humidity. So, it's not a surprise that the swamp is more humid. The swamp is filled with water for most of the year. And when that water evaporates and goes into the air, it adds to the humidity. Take a look at the remaining measurements that we took in the swamp and the sandhill. Do you see any patterns or relationships? You may have noticed that the air pressure was slightly lower each day in the sandhill. And that makes sense. You see, warmer air has lower pressure than cooler air. And every day that we took our measurements, the sandhill was warmer than the swamp. Did you notice that it was windier in the sandhill? That has to do with the plants. If you take a look at the sandhill, it's much more open. There's room for that air to move. There's nothing blocking it. In the swamp, the vegetation is dense, and that acts as a windbreak, so there's less wind in the swamp. So as you can see, environment does matter. When scientists study these weather patterns, they can help them predict the weather and help us decide what to wear to school tomorrow. I'm in front of the giant short-faced bear exhibit in the museum, and from here you can see just how tall this animal would have been. Standing at about 11 feet on its hind leg, this bear is considered megafauna. And believe it or not, it once lived in Florida. During the last ice age, Florida was host to many megafauna, including the Columbian mammoth, mastodons, saber-toothed tigers, among others. But towards the end of the last ice age, about 10,000 years ago, these animals went extinct. Why do you think they went extinct? We've been talking about weather, but there's another related term that you should know about, and that term is climate. Climate describes weather patterns over a long period of time. So think about the weather in Florida over the course of a year. I bet you could describe our summers, falls, winters, and springs pretty well. This past pattern over time is climate. And when this animal lived in Florida, the climate was very different. So as the Ice Age ended, do you think the change in climate could have affected these animals and been a reason they went extinct? Well, scientists do. It's one of several reasons that scientists give for the extinction of megafauna in Florida. You see, as it was warming up in Florida, the plants would have changed, which would have affected the plant eaters, which would have then affected the meat eaters. So what does this mean for you now? Scientists can learn from past climate changes how current climate changes can have an effect. And we know, based on weather patterns, that our climate is changing. As the climate changes, you may have to become prepared for more severe weather on a daily basis. Thank you for joining me as we've explored the topic of weather and climate. I hope you'll join me for our live Zooms on Fridays at 9:30 and 12:45. Take care.